he say that'd be called? It's over 40 years now, I think. I got out of there in 1963, I think.
L'chaim.
There was a guy who wrote a song that I really have always loved, and I hardly ever play it because I couldn't remember his name. And the other night, playing in outside of Atlanta, there was a guy in the audience who'd been at Columbia at the same time, and he knew the guy's name. Oh. So now I can play it and record it. The guy who wrote this was a guy named Danny Romer. And if anybody knows how he can be found, he was a pre-med student at Columbia. I'd really like to find the guy. He was a student of Gary Davis's, and that's obvious from what goes on in the tomb. So, I mean, if you like finger picking, I'll do it. I came to this city about a year ago. I went to see the sweetest girl I know. The kettles, they were boiling. The soup was on the stove. Open up the pot and let the high times roll. There's this little girl I know. She lives just on down the lane. Everybody knows her, and her name is Mary Jane. Everybody knows her, and we all love her so. When Mary's at a party, making them high times roll. I just figured that.
There's nobody following us.
We'll never hit 17 when you play against the dealer, because you know the odds won't ride with you. And never leave your woman alone with friends around to steal her. Years are gambled and lost like summer wages. So we'll keep rolling on until we get to Vancouver, and the woman I love is living there. It's been 6 long months, more since I've seen her. and became low, and lost like the summer away.
Thank you.
Lie. And then they'll go. go away to court another, leave you alone to pine inside. If I'd have known before I courted,
speech at one of those Folk Alliance meetings, and I started to really think about what is folk music, and well, let me say this, the guy who runs my who owns my record company once told me that when he gets to heaven, there are two things he was going to ask. What is Americana? And what is it with women and shoes? Two of the great mysteries of life right there. Americana, when I was doing stuff before I stopped for about 23 years. But before I stopped, and I was doing great, but I was working too hard. And before I stopped, there was no such thing as Americana. So they never knew where the hell to put my records. The children, there used to be these things called record stores. So when I gave the speech, I started to think real hard, what's the difference between folk music and Americana? What is folk music and what is Americana? And I came up with my own definition. I decided that folk music is some music that either has been or is performed where there's no chance of money changing hands. It's not intended to be funny. Think about it. That's folk music. It's done where it's not for dough. And Americana is stuff in that vein, but done commercially. But things turn around. You know, folk songs become Americana or rock and roll. And really, some rock and roll tunes are the new folk music. You know, a bunch of people sitting around, what are they going to sing? Climb mountains, swim oceans, go to the drugstore, buy feminine products. Don't laugh. You swallow your pride when you do that, don't you? Don't you? Gentlemen, don't you? The song kind of says it all, you know. I used to stay out every night. I'm a musician, that's what we do. And she understood that. She never said anything about it. Never complained. Tell you how dumb I am. So I stay out later. I might be gone all night long, she never said a word. Then, of course, I had to see what would happen if I stayed out a couple days. She never complained.
Looked like a wide belt.
came out and she hit the clubs. I couldn't say shit. I hope there's no other man here who ever had the experience of being out in a dance club somewhere, working the room, and the best looking woman there is more or less your old lady, and she's working it too. And it got silly, you know. I'd stay out late, she'd stay out later, I'd stay out later, she'd stay out later. I think she realized a couple of things. The first thing she realized was that she could get men a whole lot easier than I could get women. That was the first thing she realized. The second thing she realized was that she didn't need my sorry ass in that apartment for any reason under God's blue sky. I come home one morning and find everything I owned in brown supermarket paper bags outside the door, new locks. She doesn't answer when I knock. She doesn't answer when I ring.